proceeds from this run and gun match went to 22 Until Valhalla, which is a charity organization that supports the battle with veteran suicide that you see around the nation today. So proceeds from the Guardian Run and Gun went to 22 Until Valhalla. And for that, I thank you, Jim, and all the others, Elk Creek, and everybody from BDR Shooting Sports and all the competitors. So thanks again. Out. Welcome back, Run and Gunners, to another edition of Run and Gun Nation. Past weekend, I had the pleasure of doing a brand new run and gun called the Guardian Run and Gun. It was hosted by BDR Shooting Sports at Elk Creek Hunt Club just outside of Owington, Kentucky. Very first shout out will go to the match directors. That's Jim and Scott, Aaron, Craig. You guys did a fantastic job of putting on a brand new event. Short little 5K that was definitely a kicking in the nuts to anybody that showed up and did this run and gun. So going to make the commentary a little bit longer today, but still try to get through it kind of quick. And I'll talk about first the sponsors. I'm always going to do a shout out for that. You see the folks on the shirt here, some of the sponsors. They didn't actually make the cut for the shirt, but they showed up real quick. Talking about the sponsors for this run and gun, Facts and Firearms, they had actually donated a rifle that will be, it's a PCC and 9mm, I believe, that'll be raffled off later this week to everybody that competed. So everybody that actually completed and finished the event will have a chance at a raffle at the giveaway from Facts and Firearms. And another big shout out to Gun Stuff TV and Scott Kiefer, you know, our friend from Hollywood here. He and the channel at Gun Stuff TV, they donated two pistols. One being in 45 ACP and one in 9mm. The 45 ACP was the prize for the fastest in the operator class overall score, and the 9mm pistol is for the winner of the light fighter class that most people ran. For those that went out there an operator, that basically means that they had to step off and finish the entire event carrying a set amount of weight that was based upon a percentage of their body weight, and then again how much weight that extra that they had to carry during the entire event. So again, like I said, the event went off without a hitch. For Scott and Jim and Aaron and everybody else out there that put so much work into this run and gun, I can't tell you guys enough how your work paid off. I mean, these guys went out and they cut trails with machetes before they could be bush hogged. They built, you know, parts of the obstacles that we encountered along the way, made some really tough obstacles from the start, and you guys will see that in my GoPro here in a bit, and I'll give it that. Another nice thing about the course that I'll talk about is a little 5K event that was pretty much uphill the entire time. I mean, it felt like it was completely uphill the entire time we ran, and it was challenging. And then when it couldn't get any worse after going uphill for God knows how long, you encounter another obstacle that kind of smoked you before you got to the stages and everything like that. And as for the stages, like I said, these obstacles and the things that were built for the stages, it was a very heavy round count for a 5K, which I enjoyed. We shot a lot of ammo. You shot a lot of targets. And real quick side note for the folks out there at the Bluegrass. Bluegrass Targets is the one that, you know, brought all the steel out that we shot out. So a big shout out to you and you folks at Bluegrass Targets that brought out all this steel for us to shoot at. And along the way, one of the nice things was is right out the gate, they had some challenges in there. And the challenges, first, for Elk Creek Hunt Club and the BDR Shooting Sport folks are out there. Elk Creek Hunt Club is a big Sporting Clays event. So with that, they had a shotgun shoot for us with an over and under. We got to show up and shoot some clays. And if you got both of the clays, you actually got to keep your shotgun shells and you turn these in at the end. And you turn those in and you get some time off your runtime, which is really, really nice. And then throughout the course, we had very similar things like that, where if you showed up and you shot the long range stage, and you got a shot at taking around a 300 yard shot that was really hard to find after you finished the regular stage of fire, and you got yourself a nice little army man that took some time off. And then the last stage as well, after you got to shoot this mind-numbing color coordinated alphabetical order through two left side right side VTAC boards in order. If you shot that correctly in order, you actually got to take a 100 yard pistol shot. You only got one shot, and if you did that and you got a green card, and that took some more time off your runtime. And if you actually did the VTAC boards right hand and then left hand, which means that you shot the right VTAC board with your right shoulder and the left VTAC board with your left shoulder in the correct order, which you got a hint in the woods prior to showing up that would tell you the color coordinated order in alphabetical order, you would actually, if you didn't do that, you would have received a red card, and that red card would actually add some time to your runtime if you shot it out of order. So I love those kind of challenges on any running gun. Loved the round count, loved the heavy round count, can't say that enough. And had a great time out there doing, drop one. Yeah, I'm gonna get back down here, drop one. But the great patches that you guys designed for us, these are the RO t-shirts and everything out there. So I'll get into it here real quick. The gear that I ran this time, since it was a heavy round count, went with the larger war belt. This one allows me to carry more ammo with the inner liner here. This is an HSGI liner with the HSGI taco pouches for rifle and pistol. I carried four 5.56 mags, and I actually carried six 22 round 9mm mags for the M&P. Carried one up here. It's a little pouch that I use, and it's got a Safariland holster on it, and in that Safariland holster I ran the Smith & Wesson M&P in 9mm. It did great again, and it's again filthy, not too much different the way that it looked after I got done with Pawnee a couple of weeks ago. And then on the Tab Biathlon Sling, Tab Gear Biathlon Sling, I love this thing. I ran this time, I ran the Sig Sauer MCX. And I ran the Sig Sauer MCX because I just got done putting this TA-33A cog on top of it after I moved the TA-31 off of it and over to the new RDB that you saw me run in the last one. And aside from being completely filthy and I still need to clean this thing, no, that's not a baby poop paint job for all you FAL fans out there. That's just the mud that I got off of enjoying going across the slack line, which I got drug through the mud because the thing was hanging so low. So rifle did great. You guys will see that as we go through the running gun here. So that's pretty much it for the gear, all the stuff that we got. Jim, Scott, Aaron, Craig, all the other ROs that were out there that were put on a great show. We had a great weekend. They even let me set up the Nut Hut again. Set up the Run and Gun Nation rig, camped out the whole weekend. We had a little bit of weather, wasn't anything like Pawnee, but we had a little bit of weather. Had some challenges when it came to that place being completely muddy. And can't say it enough. You guys did a great job with this very first run gun. Everybody that was there. Again, another big shout out to Elk Creek Hunt Club and BDR Shooting Sports. All the sponsors, everybody that came out there and did this. Thanks again. And I'll see you guys again. And like I said earlier, the Gun Stuff TV that donated the pistols for the first place winners of the Operator Class Light. Light Fighter class. They'll actually be hosting the raffle, I think, this Thursday for that Facts and Arms firearm that's going to be raffled out to all the competitors. So tune in to Gun Stuff TV. Check out Scott's After Action when he gets it posted and edited. And I actually made an in-person appearance on there, so that'd be the live edition of Jimmy Nutt and the Run and Gun, which I think I called it this is the on-location Nuts in Your Face edition of Run and Gun Nation. So check that out Thursday. Check out Gun Stuff TV, and check out all the sponsors' websites, especially if you picked something up off of the table and brought it home after doing this. So again, for everybody out there that loves this stuff, thanks again from Run and Gun Nation. And here we go into the video. I'll let you guys see how it goes. Thanks again. Out.
Go.
Sweet. See you guys in a bit. Pull. I got a piece of it. Pull. I keep both?
You keep one and a half.
Did I flip it? Is that a hit?
There's four on there. See them?
And that's a feast.
right? Top.
Put the bottle back in the inbox.
Bottom. Ground it.
Correct.
It's on safe. And then three hits. Down. Huh? Just a safety. I'm looking for that V.
Yep.
I see it, I think. I'm gonna take a shot. Hit! Fuck me! Close, far, doesn't matter. Damn it. Is that it?
That's
for pistol.
12:20 in 3 seconds.
Holy shit.
Did you have fun?
Fuck yeah.
Am I beeping red? Look real close.
All right. Oh, I forgot I was holding your thing. I'm sorry. I probably fucked that up.
This ain't gonna fucking work, guys. Too heavy. I'm dragging down through the dirt. I'm just gonna bypass your obstacle. Because my fucking weapon is fucking ruined now.
All right, 87.16.
I fucked that all up.